Hi, I'm Aliki Pappas-Weekland, and I'm here today with Dr. Omeara Martinez, Senior Advisor for the Micronutrient Forum. We're here for the second meeting of the technical consultation, Folate Status in Women and Neural Tube Defect Risk Reduction. The Micronutrient Forum is leading this consultation, and I'm really happy to have a chance to talk with you today, Omeara.
Thanks so much.
I wanted for you to share, if you would, what new things does this consultation bring to the work of the forum?
That's a very nice way to put it. The forum has been working for several years now with different micronutrient interested groups throughout the world. But this time that we're focusing on folate deficiency and how can current knowledge be put together to reduce the risk of neural tube defects, the forum was especially interested in bringing together a multidisciplinary group of experts that could bring and shed some light into the current status of the knowledge, but especially to try to move the field further ahead. So one very interesting aspect of this consultation is the multidisciplinary nature of the committee that was put together to address the topic.
Can you share with us, I guess, a little bit more about the types of folks who are involved, the fields that have been brought together through this consultation?
Yeah, most certainly. To begin with, of course, dealing with micronutrients, we needed people with an expertise in nutrition. And we brought together people with experience in the field of, in the lab, to know how to measure folate and what may be the best indicators. We brought people who were very much aware of the role, the biological role of folate and what can be the pathways by which folate deficiency may affect health. We also wanted to have a very good sense of what are the surveillance issues related to assessing the burden of folate deficiency in the world, especially in low to middle income countries in which the surveillance systems may not be so robust for this type of deficiencies. We also wanted to have a public health approach to the topic, which is what brings us our attention to it. But we wanted to go even beyond that. So we thought about bringing the economics point of view, and we looked for economists who could help us build the investment case, why the need to address this deficiency. And given that the most effective solution to this problem at a public health level or at a population level deals with fortification of foods with folic acid, we brought an expert in food fortification. But then we even wanted to challenge the group even more by bringing someone from the innovations and technology arena to try to help us think beyond the regular or the usual solutions to the problem. So we were able to put together a rather small 10 people who formed the committee, all of them with decades of experience in the field, but who were never sat together around the same table. So that was really interesting. The first day that we sat together, there was not one person who knew all the rest, although their collective experience around the topic of folate deficiency spans for decades.
I think that's wonderful because you're bringing together these leaders in these fields, and they're strong in their own right, and then together they make an incredibly strong consultation. I think it's a fantastic approach, and I'm excited to hear what comes out of the consultation. Thinking about excitement, can you tell me what you find to be one of the more exciting pieces that's going to come from this consultation?
I think the most challenging task that we have ahead of us is to actually delineate a roadmap for action. So on the one hand, we're trying to bring the field up to date of where we are in terms of the knowledge of folate deficiency, assessment of this deficiency, interventions around this public health problem. But more than that, we want to think about the road ahead. So the challenge or the task for this consultation, for this working group, is to come up with a roadmap for action.
That's fantastic, and it's definitely something that, that is needed in the field and will benefit low middle income countries.
We are all very excited about this. I have to say that this is a highly committed group of people, a group of experts who are dedicating their time and expertise on a totally voluntary basis to move the field ahead, and all of them are highly committed and excited about making this happen.
That's wonderful. Well, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts today. Again, I'm here with Dr. Homero Martinez, Senior Advisor from the Micronutrient Forum, talking about the exciting and emerging work of the Committee for the Technical Consultation on Folate Status in Women and Neural Tube Defects Risk Reduction. Thank you.